Venus and Luna's ceremony, disclosure has begun, Archangel Abraxos, going back and thwarting the coronavirus ritual. Today's date on the Archangelic calendar is Infinity OL 9 AM to AA Infinity Infinity B 137688 Infinity Infinity B 1 TT Infinity. More information is available at archangelic calendar.com. Gaia is fire, air dominant today, this is basically what it sounds like, a flaming windstorm. This powerful force is clearly aimed at our social settings and you can fully expect a drastic and sudden change in that department. Venus and the moon are touching from our vantage point and, as all things are in divine essence and timing, this acts as a higher dimensional ceremony. This beautiful moment whereas Venus is symbolically ruling over the dark side of the moon. This is the official mark of the moon's new and improved settings bonded in love, and again thank your Lightworker Legion, for all the hard work you put in achieving this. We can sense that we are on the cusp of mainstream disclosure as more and more pedophiles are being brought to light and more corruption is being exposed, we see it the more we see it bleeding into the sleeping masses. This is in direct correlation with the many gifted fully accepting their divine power. In a system of great balance this is always the case, where you have great darkness you will summon even greater light. This grand scale awakening is a direct result of cosmic necessity, and an example of progressive propulsion, whereas the polarity of opposites push both parties into evolving. The archangel I wish to spotlight today is Archangel Abraxos, who is an extremely powerful archangel of Gaia. Abraxos is extremely earth-based and has been on earth since the first sunrise a life form has ever been present to experience it. This archangel helped bring fire to mankind and ivory to a rhino's horn. Evoke him in times of natural disasters or in times when you wish to heal someone from the animal kingdom. There is always a ritual associated with the efforts of organized darkness. This happened months ago on the 3D timelines, but for those of us who are reading this, we are way beyond space and time. That makes it as easy to fix this event as it would be anything in the perceptive present moment. It's just a matter of looking in a different location, and these are self-imposed limitations that we must break free from. The coronavirus is an attempt by organized darkness to quarantine a revolution that is on the cusp of breaking out against them. They saw this possible timeline via Project Looking Glass long before we dismantled it, and they have yet to figure out that these timelines have changed for the better. This is not an issue for us, as we are not bound by space and time. Most of humanity's 7.8 billion people do not have enough belief in their ability to work metaphysically as of yet. If that is not the case, and for most light workers it is not, feel free to use your own tools and abilities for assignments. For the others, the tools below will help you bridge the belief gap, as your belief in the said being would come into play as well. The following tools will only be available until the mark of the next Archangelic Day, next day's official post, if you are catching this on a later date. You can use the current daily tools for previous assignments. Envision yourself using said tools with a pure heart and intentions. A warning to all who try to yield unworthy, these things have their own will. Please make a mental note of what you wish to equip. Passive equals no intention needed to use or arm, it will work on its own when you accept its presence. All you need to do is give permission and it will work on your behalf. Active equals intention needed to use. Aggressive equals will attack before anything has a chance to do any harm to you. Active, passive and aggressive anywhere within the universe. The violet flame team has shifted but remains in the balance of three. It is going to be a very wild ride in the change department. The violet flame team is as follows, and is in no particular order: Archangel Zadikiel, Archangel Jamin, Archangel Ansel, Archangel Orion, Archangel Raguel, Archangel Bryathos, Archangel Sablor, Archangel Emmanuel, Archangel Bathkol, Archangel Uf, Archangel Adonai, Archangel Gzrael, Archangel Adnashiel, Archangel Azil, Archangel Tatrazil. Archangel Eshma, Archangel Abastashon, Archangel Galazur, Archangel Servil, Archangel Harahel and Archangel Vermil. Active long and short range. Archangel Michael's legendary sword can handle anything, as it is completely omnipotent. There is no level of consciousness that can be achieved that this couldn't slice through. It is also an amazing weapon against electronics and technology, as it can override any circuitry. Passive and aggressive, long or short range, anything in your jurisdiction. Archangel Leo's Swords of Plenty is a passive and aggressive attack sword that has a complete will of its own. Do not try to yield at all, you will only get in the way. Just equip and go about your day. Active long range, passive, active and aggressive short range. Archangel Isaac's radiant field looks a lot like Magneto's force field, and it reacts to any life form with either loving energy or with transmutational blast of vast power. Passive and active. Archangel Jeremiel's enhanced intuition allows the voices of your soul to become louder. It allows the judges of spirit to be more obvious than ever before. Passive, active and aggressive short range. Archangel Chamuel's radiant peace allows you to be secluded in a peaceful bubble, no matter what is happening around you. It also allows those in your heart space the same benefits. Active and passive. Vahu Mana's timeline destroyer is a great reality molder. It can help you actively destroy lower timelines that you do not wish to experience. For example, if a thought of tragedy enters your brain for no reason, use this sword to destroy that timeline so it cannot manifest. This is similar to what Michael does for us 3 sunrises ahead, except on a macro scale. Active. Archangel Saurasaha's Wand of Motion is an advanced tool, be it physical or metaphysical. This is an expert portal making device as well as a great way to move obstacles from your life. It can also be used to throw large objects at a targeted area. Passive. Archangel Raduriel's Archive Keys allows you access to new areas of knowledge and wisdom. This also gives you better access to the Akashic records. Active. Archangel Saurish's Sword of Transmutation is only for really bad energies. This is far too powerful to yield lightly. It is made for the worst of the worst. This sword will come in handy as the Rebel Legion are still involved in operations to remove the bad folks. Please note, the next 3 tools are meant to be used in combination. They are sent to us to help us sustain our physical bodies. Please keep using this tool daily. We are starting to remove the energy blockages surrounding abundance. If you need help using the below tools, envision gold bars using Archangel Ariel's wand and set it on fire using Archangel Nasaragil's and Archangel Israfil's swords. I say envision gold because Gaia controls gold and cash money. Well, ya know that story. Also, the Galactic Federation trades in gold, and manifesting in this method also aligns with their currency methods and any divinity-based currency system. Active. Archangel Ariel's Wand of Comforts helps you summon any necessity you may have. It is a wonderful and comforting tool when equipped. Active, aggressive and passive, long and short range. Archangel Israfil's Flaming Sword can protect you against all things directed to you on a macro or micro scale. It can also speed up the time in which something you wish to manifest will come to fruition. Active, aggressive and passive, long and short range. Archangel Nasaragil's Flaming Sword can bring any negative energy to its knees. It also has the ability to remove any and all obstacles that are in the way of something that you wish to manifest. 1. Stopping the coronavirus ritual is an absolute necessity. This is very similar to what we did at the Super Bowl, except in a different perceptive time. It is no different going back in time than it is going somewhere else to do remote work. The strategy is announce our arrival with the violet flame and then go in for advanced metaphysical maneuvers on all the priests and priestess performing the ceremony. 2. After yesterday's Golden Heart of Gaia assignment, we discovered a tremendous amount of a mucus-like substance. The mantis suggest going in and removing it by hand. 3. There is a false projection coming from the Orion constellation in the belt region from our vantage point. The meditation below is not part of mandatory assignments, please partake at your leisure. More information is available at archangelickcalendar.com. Please do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe.